Well, let's say that the situation changes in Washington mm-hmm. in the near future, and you know, Republicans are put in a place where they can take action mm-hmm. and act. Do you think that Speaker Boehner will take the necessary steps to curb the debt problem?
Well, if we win back the Senate, if we're fortunate enough in 2012 to win back the Senate, and if we're fortunate enough to have a Republican in the White House, I think you're going to see more positive things happen relative to our overall fiscal situation, and frankly, our tax code as well. And our regulatory burdens that we place on job creators. So I think all those things are positive. But I will tell you, I do think we need to continue to fight now, because the window of opportunity to fix things is closing pretty rapidly. And you can't keep waiting, well, once we get this, we'll do it. Then once we get that, we'll do it. We need to be after fixing things right now.
What if conservatives, or the people who call themselves conservatives in the House, aren't really up for that challenge? Do you think that we could see a speaker's race? Could we see a Speaker Jordan?
No. I'm not. I don't want to be speaker. And John Boehner's doing a good job. What I do think is, if we can win back the Senate and the White House, then we have to make the tough choices, do the tough things to grow our economy and reduce spending, so we can solve this problem. And put us on a path that makes sense, that's actually sustainable.
What do you think is going to happen the next time this debt ceiling issue comes up?
Well, it'll come up here in a few months with this commission that was in the legislation is going to come back with their recommendations on dealing with the annual deficit and further savings. I think there's a potential with this commission, this is a real concern I have, they may recommend some tax increases, which is obviously not what we want. That's not going to help promote economic activity and job creation. So we have to wait and see what they bring back. I think we're going to find out here in the next week or so who's on the commission. That's step one. What members of Congress, both House and Senate, sit on the commission. But that'll tell you whether there's a likelihood there'll be tax increases or not.
Congressman, what's the biggest issue facing young people, and why should young people be involved in the movement? Obviously, we're Young America's mm-hmm. Foundation, and we want, you know, we see this as a big time. But mm-hmm. why would you say that young people should be involved in the
movement? Well, you've said it, because if The fiscal situation is such that if we don't begin to turn things around, the debt burden that younger Americans are going to have to assume is just huge. Jefferson talked about every generation should pay off its own debts. You shouldn't send it to the next generation. And we're at that point where it looks like we're going to send a big burden to the next generation and not pay off the spending that our generation allowed to happen. So that is probably the biggest issue. But in some ways, too, it's the values fights. I mean, the idea that there are certain principles that matter and are worth fighting. The free market, the work ethic principle, you know, just basic fundamental principles that the respect for human life, all things that conservatives should care about. Those are important, too, because if you get away from a market-oriented economy, then you start to have problems. We saw that with the bank bailout issues and the auto bailout issues just a few years ago. You want a strong emphasis on free markets and true capitalism.
Well, what can students do to get involved? What would you tell the students at home?
Just keep doing what you're doing. Get involved with this great organization. Run for office. Get involved with your local party structure. And as I said to the group earlier today, never let people tell you can't accomplish something that you really want to accomplish. America is a story of people overcoming the conventional wisdom and doing things no one thought they could do. And so that's, I think, just a great message for young people to always remember. You set goals, you work hard, good things can happen.
Congressman Jordan, thanks for joining us.
Thank
Appreciate
you.
It.